Well, I do hope that at the end, a part of the world of, I mean, the war of words that always there is in this kind of situation, the good sense will prevail, and everyone will notice that kind of budget is exactly what Italy needs at the moment in order to cope with its chronic lack of growth. All the rest is perfect in Italy in terms of economic number, balance, trade surplus, primary balance surplus that most of our fellow European doesn't boast. The only real problem is the lack of growth, and the lack of growth is driven by lack of internal demand. So the only thing that we cannot do is to do something that is going to depress furthermore internal demand.
One of the criticisms people have leveled against this plan, when you focus on increasing growth using the measures that you're proposing, is that that demand is only boosted for a year or two. Why do you think that analysis might be wrong?
It's like to start an engine. What at the moment Italy need is to start the engine and to start a sort of positive cycle that is going to be sustainable. If ever we keep on depressing the demand with the austerity policy that has been, at least clearly failing their objective in the past, basically it was a death spiral. I mean, people got taxed more, spend less, company shut down, they fire people, and basically it was a doom loop. Instead, we have to make the initial push in order to reverse this kind of spiral, and I do think that it's the right thing to do.
What about structural reforms? Some of those are in this plan going to be reversed slightly, and there are plans to reverse others in the future. Is that not something that needs to be addressed? The structural problems in Italy's economy need to be solved by whoever is in government.
Definitely, but one should be clear about what is a reform. Every government makes reforms. Every law, basically, it's per se a reform. Problem is that many structural reform that has been done in the past basically show themselves to be very pro-cyclical. For example, if when we were in a recession, we made firing workers easier. Well, of course it adds flexibility, but if ever you are in a recession, basically makes the recession worse. The same is, for example, for the pension. If we lock the people in the job forever, like the reform of the pension did in the past, basically you save money in terms of state budget. The problem is that the companies are saddled by employees that at the moment are not coping with the challenge of the market that is changing. So basically they need to have a generational shift. So basically, we are helping them to do exactly this.
Hey, everybody, it's Hadley Gamble from our new CNBC Middle East Bureau in Abu Dhabi. Thanks for stopping by. Now, to watch more, you can try one of the videos that just popped up on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe.